Hello, I am Satyabroto. Welcome to my channel. If you like my videos, then share and subscribe my channel and don't forget to click the bell icon. So in my previous videos, I have discussed about introduction to resonance, scheme of drawing resonance and the result of resonance, that is stability. I have told that higher the number of canonical structure, higher will be the stability of the molecule. So today I am thinking that I will give you some examples of complicated resonance structure. So because as a first time learner, it is not a easy task to draw the resonance structure correctly. Okay, first I'm giving the examples of nitrobenzene. Usually we don't show the hydrogen. Okay, so better to not showing the hydrogen. Okay, nitrobenzene, N double bond O, O minus, and usually it is better to show the lone pair. Oxygen has two lone pair and here nitrogen has three lone pair. Okay, and see, number of bond arising from this nitrogen is 4. That is why we need to put a positive charge on nitrogen atom. So positive charge is on nitrogen atom and negative charge is on oxygen atom. So overall molecule is neutral. Okay, so nitrogen actually electron negative element, where positive charge resides on nitrogen atom, so it doesn't like, so it try to withdraw the electron density. So pi electron, this pi bond comes here, that is pi electron comes between this carbon and this nitrogen. So there will be formation of double bond. When there will be formation of double bond, obviously the number of bond arising from nitrogen increases to 5, which is not possible. So this bond breaks. Okay, so double headed structure arrow, what we use for resonance structure. These two double bond will be intact. So there is the position of these two double bonds will not change. O minus and O minus, because this pi bond now moves on pi electrons, now moves on oxygen. So there will be new lone pair, and again number of bond arising from nitrogen is 4, so we need to put a positive charge. And here number of bond arising from this carbon is 3. Actually we have not shown the hydrogen, so if we consider the hydrogen, then number of bond arising from this carbon is 3. That is why we need to put a positive charge. Okay, so you can calculate the formal charge on this nitrogen atom, and then you need to consider the number of bond arising from this carbon is 3, because one bond and the second bond and third bond we have not shown, that is high CH bond. So in positive charge. Okay, and now just think, we have the XYZ skeleton, X double bond Y Z plus, then see this pi bond moves between Y and Z, just we are mimicking this double bond, and this double bond will be are intact, these two will not change, and it is better to show the lone pair. Now again number of bond arising from this carbon is 3, because we have not shown the hydrogen atom. We usually don't show the hydrogen atom. Positive charge, again see X double bond Y Z plus, this pi electron moves between Y and Z, sorry I have forgot to put a positive charge on nitrogen atom. Now this O minus, either of these two negative charge on oxygen atom. Now one lone pair will form the pi bond between nitrogen and oxygen. When there will be formation of pi bond between this nitrogen and this oxygen, the number of bond arising from this nitrogen will be 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which is not possible. So to maintain the tetravalency of nitrogen, this pi bond breaks. Okay, these are the 1, 2, 3, 5 canonical structures of nitrobenzene. And see, in all canonicals are neutral because nitrobenzene is a neutral molecule. Okay, so you need to maintain the charge, because if the molecule is neutral, then all the canonical structure should be neutral. Now, what happens? Now, try to concentrate on the canonical structure. Canonical structure. Here, nitro group, actually NO2 group withdraws the electron density. NO2 group withdraws the electron density from benzene ring through pi bond. That is why this is called negative resonance effect or minus R effect. And due to minus R effect, electron density in benzene ring decreases. Okay? So, the result, then what happens if electron density in benzene ring decreases? That will be discussed later in aromatic nucleophilic substitution. Okay, or in aromatic electrophilic substitution, the consequences of decreasing electron density on benzene ring, then what happens? Okay, that will be discussed later. Don't worry. Okay, so this type of resonance, like similarly NO2 group, so minus R effect shows by NO2 group, aldehyde group, acid group, like aldehyde or carbonyl group, cyano group. Okay, this group shows the minus R effect, that is withdrawing electron density. Actually, this group withdraws the electron density from benzene ring or any other molecule through pi bond. Okay, these functional groups shows minus R effect. So you can try to draw the resonance structure of benzaldehyde, resonance structure of benzoic acid, or resonance structure of cyanobenzene. So if you have any problem, then try to contact with me, or if you have any problem drawing this resonance structure of benzaldehyde or benzoic acid, then write in the comment section. I will help you. Now consider this molecule, phenol. Oxygen atom here, number of lone pair on oxygen atom is 2. Okay, so X double bond Y, instead of Z minus, one can assume that, or one can think that Z contains lone pair, 1 or 2. Okay, then what will happen? We know this one. Then similarly, this lone pair moves between carbon and oxygen, and when this lone pair moves between this carbon and oxygen, then there will be formation of new pi bond. If new pi bond forms, then number of bond arising from this carbon increases to 5, which is not possible. So that is why this pi bond breaks, and the pi electrons comes or moves on this carbon. These two double bond, they are unchanged. The position of these two double bonds are unchanged. OH, and there will be negative charge. Now, the number of bond arising from this oxygen is now 3. So when number of bond arising from oxygen atom is 3, then you need to put a positive charge on oxygen atom, because if you calculate the formal charge on oxygen atom, like trivalent oxygen atom, then you need to put a positive charge on that oxygen atom. Now it is very simple. Now X double bond Y, Z minus, just I am mimicking. Then again, we can assume X double bond Y Z minus. Now, yes, this one. Now, the positive. Now, oxygen atom gets neutralized. Okay. Now see this phenol, okay, and phenol contains hydroxyl group, okay. So functional group is OH. We know that OH, where oxygen is electronegative element. So we know electronegative element has minus I effect. It means electron withdrawing effect through sigma bond. But here, hydroxyl group imparts electron donating effect through pi bond. So here hydroxyl groups donates electron density through pi bond into the benzene ring. So what will the result? Result is the electron density on benzene ring increases. Okay, and it has some it imparts effect on aromatic electrophilic substitution or aromatic nucleophilic substitution. Those thing I will be discussed later. So here try to concentrate that hydroxyl group donates electron density through pi bond into the benzene ring. Okay, so that is why these effects are called Placer effect. So Placer effect is shown by hydroxyl group. This group, NH2 group, okay, or chlorine, okay. So these groups are like groups having lone pair, okay. Functional groups having lone pair, usually they so Placer effect, and result is that increase of electron density in benzene ring. Okay, so but these are all electronegative element. They also shows minus I effect, but always try to keep in mind that R effect is stronger than I effect. Okay. Try to practice to draw the resonance structure of aniline on anisole in home. Okay. And if you find any difficulties, then write in the comment section. I can help you. Here I am going to show you another interesting resonating structures of 1-methoxy-1,3-butadiene. So first, I am drawing the structure. CH2 double bond, CH single bond, double bond, CH, OCH3. And OCH3 group, here oxygen has two lone pair and double bond, single bond, double bond. This is conjugated system because here double bond, then single bond, again double bond. So it is a conjugated system. And we know OCH3 group has Plasar effect, so it donates the electron density in this conjugated motif. Okay, then what happens when lone pair oxygen atom forms the new pi bonds here, then this pi bond breaks, we'll have CH2 double bond, CH minus, because we know that electron density on this conjugated system increases because OCH3 has Plasar effect. As now oxygen has 3 bond, so that is why we need to put a positive charge. Okay, then again this negative charge forms the new pi bond between this carbon and these two carbon. Then when there is a formation of new pi bond, then this pi bond breaks and the pi electron now moves on this carbon atom. So negative charge resides on this terminal carbon atom. So this is a very interesting resonating structure of 1,3-1-methoxy, because this is methoxy group. This is methoxy group. 1-methoxy-1,3-butadiene. Okay, so thanks for watching. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe for more. Bye.